We are going to consider the chirality of biphenyls. That is the third topic of this stereochemistry chapter, right? So now let us consider biphenyls. Biphenyls is nothing but the, someone we can call it as a diphenyl. It is also known as a phenylbenzene or 1,1-biphenyl, or it is also known as laminol. So these are the different names of biphenyls. So there are some common names, there are some IUPAC nomenclature system. So the biphenyl compound are colorless compound and it has a distinctly pleasant smell. So the biphenyl compound is an aromatic hydrocarbon with the molecular formula C6H5 twice. So you can see here there are two rings joined with a single bond, right? So this is A ring and this should be a B ring. Okay, these two rings are joined with a single bond. So you can see also the one ring contains six number of carbon atoms and five hydrogen atoms. Here it is also, these are the six number of carbon atoms and five hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4 and five hydrogen atoms are there. Okay, this is the basic structure of biphenyls, right? So next is we are going to consider the stereochemistry of biphenyls. So here it is, the biphenyl has, already I said that the biphenyl ring has two phenyl rings, which is attached by a single bond known as pivotal bond. So the pre-rotation across the pivotal bond, that pre-rotation across the pivotal bond is possible and here the molecule becomes a coplanar. So you can see here, so this particular structure, this particular ring, and this is known as a pivotal bond, okay? This is ring A, this is ring B. This particular bond is known as pivotal bond. Okay, and due to this, the rotation between these two rings is possible. By keeping one ring fixed, another ring can be rotated, or by keeping another ring, second ring will be rotated. So these two rings are always in planar without substitute. Okay, there is no, so you can see here, there is no substitute in either the ring A or B. Okay, so such type of bond is known as pivotal bond. So, but due to the presence of this pivotal bond, this particular molecule can be rotated. The rotation can be restricted when the molecule is substituted. So this ring is substituted ring, right? Here it is A and B substituted on the ring. This, we can say this is the first ring. And this is first ring and this is second. Okay. In the first ring, you can see there are two substituents. This is A and this is B. In the second ring, there are another two substituents are there. So due to this, the rotation around this pivotal bond is restricted. It is prevented. So, and due to this, these two rings are not in the planar molecules. They are not, cannot be considered as a planar molecules. Here it is, you can see these two rings are in a plane. Both lie in the same plane. But due to presence of these bulky groups at ortho position of each ring, the rotation around this pivotal bond is going to be restricted or prevented. Due to this, these molecules cannot be any more planar molecules. So they are not planar. Okay. So restricted rotation around this bond, rotation is restricted. So you can consider restricted rotation. And due to this, they are not planar molecule. So they are not planar molecule. Right? So here it is, rotation is possible. Rotation is possible. Possible. And due to this, these are coplanar. These are coplanar molecules. Okay. And similarly, and the next one is, you can see here, this first ring, first type of ring, here it is, there is no substituent. This is totally unsubstituted biphenyl system. Here it is, the substitution are there at each ortho position of both the rings. Similarly, the third structure is also having substitution. But according to the optical activity, these are unsubstituted biphenyls are always optically inactive because they may possess a plane of superiority. If you pass a plane like that, then the molecules is exactly bisect into two halves. Okay, exactly two halves. So when the molecule possesses any kind of symmetry, they are always optically inactive. Okay. Similarly, in the second structure, when you are going to pass a plane, so if you pass plane, these two rings are twisted to each other, right? One ring, these two groups should be are out of the plane, and these are in the plane molecules. Okay. The ring is always like. Okay, so these two rings are coplanar rings, right? But they have substituent. In this ring, all the substituents, in the first ring, there are two substituents which are different, A and B. In the second ring, there are two substituents which are different. So this molecule is always optically active because it does not possess any kind of symmetry. But when we are going to move towards this structure, you can see here the ring, first ring having two different substituents. But second ring having two substituents that both are identical. So therefore, it means when we pass a plane, when we pass a plane through this ring, so it equally bisects. You can see this is half part, which is mirror image of this half part. So it means this ring should be equally distributed, right? So this ring possesses some kind of symmetry. So due to this, the whole molecule is optically inactive because symmetry, if symmetry is present in any one of the ring or whole molecule, then the molecule is always optically active. So you should always remember that the when we are going to consider the biphenyl system, look at the substituents. What are the substituents present at the ortho positions? Okay, if they are same, that means the molecule possesses symmetry. If they are different, then the molecule does not have symmetry. So you can consider this molecule as optically inactive, even though it is a coplanar. You can see here, this is a coplanar, but it is inactive. The reason is that it possesses plane of symmetry. It is inactive, okay? And this is active. So now let us consider why these molecules are active and these molecules are active, these two molecules are inactive. Now look at here. So here it is. You can see here, this ring is in the plane ring, right? This ring is in the plane, you can see, and this is out of the plane. Okay, this ring should be horizontal place, and this is out of the plane. These bonds are away from and this towards the observer. Okay. So these are lie above, these are lie below. So when such kind of ring is there, if you pass the plane in any one of the ring, you can see here. You can see here, there is no element of symmetry. You can see here, there is no element of symmetry. You can pass the plane. So there is no element of symmetry because when you see other side of this plane, there is A group, but inside there is a B group. So it means they are not mirror image, they are different. Similarly in this case, so this molecule does not possess any kind of plane of symmetry. So therefore, this is optically active molecule, right? Now, when you are going to consider second molecule, that is this one. So in this case, there is no substituent. If you pass a plane of symmetry, either ring, both the ring possesses plane of symmetry. So the for the optical activity of biphenyl system, there are different types of conditions. So here it is, you can see both the ring possesses symmetry. Here it is, none of the ring possesses symmetry. So it is optically active, and this one is optically inactive because it possesses symmetry in both the rings. Because when you are passing the plane, the molecule is equally distributed in both the rings. Okay, so therefore it is optically inactive. So it is inactive. This is inactive. This is active. Okay, same in the case of third molecule. You can see here in the third molecule. So there are all the ortho position of these two rings are substituted. So either in the case of pairing or in the case of this. So when you are going to pass a plane, if you are going to pass a plane from this line, this ring, you can see here, the ring cannot be divided into equal parts, right? So this part is not mirror image of this part. So this ring possesses none of the plane, none of symmetry. Okay,
while you, when you are going to pass a plane in the second ring, you can see that this ring is exactly equally distributed in two halves. So this half is equally exactly mirror image of this half. So it means the ring, second ring, possesses plane of symmetry. Therefore, the molecule is optically inactive. So again, second molecule is optically inactive. This is inactive. Okay, you can consider this as an inactive molecule. Now, when a biphenyl system containing four large groups, as already told that the molecule possesses some kind of symmetry, but depending upon the four groups. So here it is, you can see that these two rings have four different groups, right? So these are large groups. So due to this, the pre-rotation is impossible, right? So pre-rotation is impossible. As earlier case, when the ring is unsubstituted, the rotation can be possible. Due to this, the molecules, the two preanion rings are exist in a planar nature. We can call it as coplanar. Both the rings are in plane. But due to presence of these groups, these are bulky groups, right? CH is bulky group. Fluorine is small group, but the CH is very bulky group. So due to this, the rotation around this pivotal bond is restricted. Okay? But due to this, this particular molecule exists in different types of isomer. When we are going to consider its mirror image, the molecule exists in two different types. So it means this molecule has two isomers. If you are going to consider its isomer, so now when we are going to consider the mirror image of this molecule, wait a minute. So we can consider this molecule, when we are going to take its mirror image, it looks like this one, right? So if you place this mirror image over this molecule, you can see that there is a difference, right? So this particular ring is A ring and this second ring should be B ring. Similarly, here it is A ring appears on this side and B ring appears on this side. So these two are mirror images. If you place this mirror image over this original image, then this B is overlapping over A. So that means these are not identical. If A is overlapping over the A, that means we can consider these two rings are, these two isomers are similar. But these two mirror images are different. So the biphenyl molecules possess different types of stereoisomers and they are mirror, non-superimposable mirror images. So these two isomers are non-superimposable mirror images. That means the molecule possesses optical activity, because these are the isomers which are non-superimposable. As we already seen that when the molecules having non-superimposable mirror images, they are chiral and the chiral molecule is active molecule. So here in this case, this molecule is optically active because its isomer are non-superimposable. They are separable. Okay. So therefore, we can call it as a chiral compound. So apart from this type of isomerism arises due to whatever the isomerism arises here, that is due to the restricted rotation across this carbon-carbon bond, right? Single bond. And this particular isomer is known as atrop isomerism. This is known as atrop isomerism, and the isomers are called as atrop isomers. So the optical activity of biphenyl depends on the size of the substituent. Okay, whatever the substituent is present on the ortho position, these will be the most important factor for the deciding optical activity of the biphenyl system. So the steric hindrance produced by the various group restricted the rotation about the pivotal bond. Whatever the groups present at this ortho position, it involves in the steric hindrance, and due to this, the rotation is restricted, therefore which causes the optical activity. Molecule shows different types of isomer and they can be called as an optical activity. Now let us consider some example. Okay, here I'm going to consider some example for the optical activity. Here it is, this is a biphenyl system. Now here it is, the substituent is NO2. In this case, there is a COH. Here it is, another substituent is COH. The name of this molecule is 6-nitrophenyl. It is 6-nitrophenyl. The numbering pattern of biphenyl system is not our part of this chapter, okay, that we can study later. But the name of this compound is 6-nitrophenyl 2-2-2-2-dicarboxylic acid. Okay, so here you can consider this particular molecule when we are going to pass a plane up from this first ring. So there are two different groups, so therefore this ring do not possess any kind of symmetry. While you are going to pass in this plane of symmetry in the second molecule, so you can see here there is a CH group on another side. At second ortho position there is a hydrogen. So both are the different groups. So both the ring possesses, both the ring do not have any kind of symmetry. So they do not have any symmetry. Here it is, the reason is that the molecule do not have any symmetry. Okay. So it is optically active. If it is optically active, that means it has two isomers. That things also remember. Okay. It has two stereoisomers. Okay. Now let us consider second example. In the second example, this is COH and this is also COH. Okay, so this particular group is known as the diphenyl 2-2- dicarboxylic acid. Okay, so now look at here. So both the ring having only one substituent, but the substituent is very bulky. So due to this bulky substituent, the rotation is impossible. The rotation between the pivotal wall is impossible or restricted. So this molecule possesses two isomers. You can see when you are going to pass a plane, the molecule is not divided into two equal halves. If you pass a plane, the molecule is not going to be divided into two equal halves. If you pass this plane, there is no two half in this ring. Again, similarly, this ring also do not have any mirror images on the other side. So the molecule is do not have any kind of symmetry. Same observation will be here. Molecule do not have any kind of symmetry. So the optical active, therefore it possesses two isomers. So there are different types of examples from that you can understand the stereochemistry of biophenyls. Okay.